Hi, welcome to a video tutorial from Robojax. In this video we are going to build this Tesla coil. And as you can see here, the Tesla coil is now running. Then we will see that this light will turn on without any wire. So let's get started. Let me briefly explain the schematic diagram. So we are connecting it to 15 to 24 volts through these pins, so VCC and ground, and then VCC, which is a positive, will be connected to these points, and then ground is connected to these three points of ground. So VCC is connected to the drain of this MOSFET transistor, and it comes from the source. Because this MOSFET is on, so this will be always on here. It's connected to this 2 kilo ohm resistor. Of course, it will have some oscillation, will have effect of it, but it's very low resistance, so it will be turned on, and it's connected to the collector. From collector, we go to the biasing resistor, and then it goes to the LED. So then from the collector through the one wire, this is the one turn wire, which is around the main coil. It goes to the collector and emitter. So this transistor will start oscillating due to existence of this capacitor here and this inductor here. So this RC filter will start filling on and then connecting and then filling off. So this will continuously start oscillating, and then one turn will induce to 350 turn winding on the secondary, which are the tiny winding, and then the voltage will be 350 times higher. So if this is 15 volts and the resistance is zero, so we have 15 times 100 will be induced here. And on this side, it's connected to the base via this white LED. This is the red LED, which shows the power. So we will see the through the air molecules, so it will be connected to the ground. So that's why you will see some spark here. Then we have here a 3.5 millimeter jack is connected to the audio source. So we are connecting it for the ground. We are connecting it to the positive through this 1 microfarad capacitor, and from this side it's connected to the collector. And as a result, when the beat goes up and down, it disturbs the oscillation accordingly, either towards positive or towards negative. And consequently, we should see the result in the spark here. So the spark should be reduced, increased or decreased with the beats of music. So let's start with these small components. So we have one pair of resistor, another pair. The one that has a red at the middle, that is a 10 kilo ohm. And then the one that has red at the beginning, this is the 2 kilo ohm. 10 kilo ohm goes, one goes here and one goes here. And 2 kilo ohm, it goes here, the long one. These two have label, these two have no value, so that is the one. For the LEDs, we have one red and then one white LED. So there are two LED spots here. So red LED goes here and white LED goes here. So let's start with these. And then we have one capacitor. That's the only capacitor, the electrolytic capacitor. This capacitor is larger, which you will not make a mistake, that goes in here. So we will put the component from this side and solder them on the other side. The 2 kilo ohm resistor, now I put the 10 kilo ohm here, and the 2 kilo ohm resistor, one goes here and then one goes here. To insert the LED, make sure that the long pin is the positive one. So I'm inserting the red. And here It has been labeled, so positive is this side and the long, so put the long here. And same thing for the white, the positive is on the other side. Now insert the capacitor here, the long pin is positive in here. Bend it and then solder. So it doesn't have polarity, just insert it and solder it. This is the audio jack. So this is the jack that they sent, and this is the one that we need. If you look here, the jack that they sent is very cheap, low quality, and it's missing one pin. It's supposed to have another pin here. So I'm going to insert this jack, but for you, just solder here a wire and then insert it. Okay, so these two are connected together. These are one wire. One of the clipped wire from the resistor, just solder it here and solder the other side. This jack that I have with three pins. B0243. So this is the spot is already labeled here, B0. So this goes here, and the other one will go there. To insert this here, side that is flat, we put it in order to facilitate the heat transfer from the transistor to the heatsink. They give you the thermal grease here, so we will apply a little of this. The MOSFET, insert it, a little up, but here make sure that when I touch it, it should not touch because the heatsink will be one of the pin and I don't want any interference. Now it comes to the coil. The coil has two wire, one is very short on this side and the other one, if I remove it, will be very long. So this is the long portion of the coil. So this is the long side. You do not solder it. The one that is shorter will be soldered in here. And then I'm gonna put the glue here to hold this in place. So I will just apply here some glue. And then the side that is short will go down. Make sure that this side, because I'm gonna solder it in here, the wire is closer to that side. The standoff can be used with this one, so we can screw it here. So 20 volts, I'm gonna connect when 20 volts. The coil is ready. I'm connecting it. I've turned off the light so you can see it better. And this is the light. And they give me this small neon light, so now I'm getting it closer so to see from far away. It just turns on. Now I'm parallel with this like that, so going away. So this is about 5-6 centimeters. away on it. Lights up very strong from this far. And it vibrates. I don't know why. It just constantly vibrates when I get closer. This one, it just turns on from further distance. It's already on. I have some music here from YouTube playing, and the cable is connected here, and amazingly so the music is connected here, but I can hear the music from this device. So here you see, the music stopped.